Today I'm going to talk about dual access stepper drivers. On the MKS Gen L, we can only use one stepper unless we use a divider or we add a second stepper with one of our auxiliary pins. In this case, I'm going to show you how to do it with steppers. So let me review what our steppers are real quick here. We have our X stepper, our Y stepper driver port, our Z stepper driver port, our E0 stepper driver port, and then we have our extruder E1 stepper port. So what we're going to do is we're going to configure the Marlin firmware to run the stepper driver from the Z port as well as the E1 port, as long as we don't have a second extruder. So in order to do this, first of all, we have to make sure that we have all our jumpers connected for the ports that we're using, because that gives us the highest degree of step. So the jumpers are already on. And then what we need to do is add the stepper drivers. So we have to find the enable pin, and I'm not going to go over it too much in this video. You can always watch my other videos where I talk about how to calibrate it and insert it, which if this is the first time you watch this video, you probably want to watch those. So as you can tell, both steppers are inserted for the Z axis and for E1. Note the potentiometer is facing away from the power supply on both. That means that the enable pin is over here and over here, and the enable pin down here is set to that as well. Now we need to use Z min, and if you look really closely down here on your MKS Gen L, you'll see that there is a voltage, ground, and signal. We're going to connect our Endstop to this, but what we're going to use is we're going to use the ground and the signal pin on X-min. So next thing we want to do is connect the stepper drivers. So we're going to connect E1 with our first motor, and we're going to connect the Z axis with the second one. Now keep in mind that we want to have the colors of the wires exactly the same for both, and we're going to insert that. And then in a moment, I'm going to show you in the Marlin firmware how to set this up. But before I do that, I want to show you how to connect the USB cable. Now you want to connect the first side, or the big side, to the board. And you want to connect the small side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. And in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware, but just keep in mind, do not touch this area of the board now that it's been energized with the USB. Okay, we're going to open up the folder for Marlin-1.1.8. We're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. We're going to press M on the keyboard and scroll down to marlin.ino and press enter. Okay, we're going to go to the configuration.h tab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And as you can see, the board is specified as board_ramps_14_EFB. Now keep in mind that this is the same architecture as the MKS Gen L. So now we're going to go over to the configuration.h tab, and we're going to search on Z dual. And what we want to do is uncomment the line for define space Z_dual_stepper_drivers. Now keep in mind that there are various settings in here that you can try, like dual end stops, but you don't need that because it's only one access. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to check to see that tools ports is selected, which it is.
And then, as you can see, we have the architecture for loading for a Arduino Mega 2560. So we're good there. So all we have to do is compile and upload with the upload button. Now keep in mind, in a moment, I'll show you how to test it in Pronterface. So here we go.
Okay, the first thing that we need to do is plug in the power. Now keep in mind, I wired this up and I'll talk about this in future tutorials. So keep in mind, this is energized and unsafe to touch when the power is applied. So I'm gonna plug that in. And in a moment, in Pronterface, I'll show you how to test it.
Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder, so we're gonna open up Pronterface. We're gonna connect to the printer. Now we're gonna type M119 to find out what the status of the end stops are. And because we're using the Z axis, it is specified as open. So in a moment, I'm gonna show you how to test it by homing the Z axis to X-Men. But keep in mind, the reason that I used the Marlin firmware for 1.1.8 is because 1.1.9 appears not to work stably. So you might have varying results with this. So here we go. So there we go. Now all we have to do is double check to see that we're back to the same state with the end stops with M119, which we are. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.